Hi friends, welcome to day 3 to solve UPSC prelims questions 2019. Today we are going to deal with the sections history and geography. I'm Uma Maheshwari and I have cleared civil services exam 2018. To know more about me, please pass the slide and read the info. Let's begin to one. Which one of the following is not a Harappan site? Which is question number 1. For this we have to use the elimination method. Channudaru, if you had read in the NCERT, it is very famous for beads industry, bangle beads especially. And Kot Diji, it was a place which was destroyed completely by fire and the ruins were there. And so the confusion occurs between Sohagwara and Desalpur. Sohagwara is in UP and this is the answer because this is not a Harappan site. And Desalpur, it is there in the Kutch area and it may be used as port in the Indus Valley Civilization. So the answer to this question is C, Sohagwara. And here Ashokan inscriptions were found. You can see where Desalpur is there. This is Desalpur, Kot Diji and Channudaru. All these are Harappan sites. Question number 2. Which of the following relief sculpture inscriptions is Ranyu Ashoka, King Ashoka, mentioned along with the stone portrait of Ashoka? To answer this question, you must have known about the fact no guessworks in such questions will be prospective. So the answer to this question is A, Kanganahalli. You can see. In this, the important finding of this excavation is a stone sculptured slab and it bears the name of the King Ashoka. Question number 3. With reference to forced labor or Vishti in India during the Gupta period, which of the following are correct? See, forced labor was very, very much prevalent during the Gupta times. And it was considered as a source of income for the state, a sort of tax paid by the people. So the answer is A. It was totally absent. No, it was very much prevalent in Madhya Pradesh. And no, other options are also wrong. You can read the details here. And if you have time, please do read Upinder Singh's History of Ancient and Early Medieval India. Because sometimes UPSC feels this book is special and some questions are taken from this question, from this book directly. Question number 4. In the revenue administration of Delhi Sultanate, the in-charge of revenue collection was known as Amil. Yes, this is correct. The Ikta system of Sultans of Delhi was an ancient indigenous institution. No, this is wrong. It is not an indigenous institution. The office of Mir Bakshi came into existence during the reign of Khilji Sultans of Delhi. This is also wrong because if you have read the NCERT thoroughly, you would have known that Mir Bakshi, the office of Mir Bakshi belonged to the Mughal administration. So the answer to this question is A, 1 only. You can see in the Delhi Sultanate period, the divisions were provinces were divided into sheikhs or districts. And the sheikh was controlled by the sheikhdar. And each district or sheikh, it comprised of few parganas or kasbas. See, this is the province and this is the sheikh. The province was divided into sheikhs and the sheikhs were divided into parganas. Province, sheikhs and parganas. So the sheikh was controlled by sheikhdar and the parganas. The government officials of a Pargana after Sheikhdar was Amils. So the Parganas were controlled by the Amil who collected the revenue. And the Iktas, they started in 1206 itself and it was not indigenous. Mir Bakshi means the head of military department. Question number 5. Deification of the Buddha, treading the path of Bodhisattvas, image worship and rituals. Yes, all these three are features of Mahayana Buddhism. So, the answer to this question is actually D, 1, 2 and 3. See, the concept of Mahayana Buddhism, the Mahayana sect, it emerged during the 1st century during the reign of Kanishka. And they were, Bodhisattvas were perceived as extremely compassionate, very, very compassionate because they did not use their effort to attain Nirvana, but they abandoned the world to help the other peoples. To help others in the path of Nibbana. Great, right? Building Kalyana Mandapas was a notable feature in the temple construction in the kingdom of. Again, another fact based question, and the direct answer to this question is D. Vijayanagara. So, if you have read history, please do read Vijayanagara Empire in detail, because every year one or two questions are asked from this kingdom, Vijayanagara Kingdom. So, yes, you can see how wonderful this Kalyana Mandapa, which belongs to Vijayanagara architecture. In this Kalyana Mandapa, what happens is the celebrations of divine weddings, they happen here. Question number 7, saying Nimbaga was a contemporary of Akbar. See, such tough questions are also asked in history. So, you need not read extensively for it. But when you read something, read every detail in minute. Okay, when you read a book, revise it several times and also look into the intricate details of whatever you read. So, Saint Nimbaga was a contemporary of Akbar. No, actually, Akbar belonged to 15th century and Saint Nimbaga to 13th century. So, this is wrong. Saint Kabir was greatly influenced by Sheikh Ahmad Sirhindi. This is very absurd, because Sheikh Ahmad Sirhindi, he belonged to Naqshbandi school, and they were actually starting a crusade against the Hindus. And they also believed that Sufism was very much orthodox, and they wanted to establish Islam everywhere. But Saint Kabir is a peaceful poet, and he had the influence of both Hinduism and the Muslim, Islam, and he told that Ram and Rahim are one. And so the answer to this question is D, neither one nor two. Please look into the details here. And also, you can find out that Sheikh Ahmad Sirhindi was born after Kabir. So, Kabir would not have been influenced by his thoughts. His concept was Allah and Ram were but names of same God. With reference to Mian Tansen, which one of the following statement is not correct? So, when you read about such secular poets or some unique people, please do read the details very carefully. So, Tansen was the title given to him by Emperor Akbar. No, it is wrong actually, because Emperor Akbar gave him the title of Mian and not Tansen. So, this is the direct answer, because the question is which is not correct. Tansen composed Drupads on Hindu gods and goddesses. Yes, this is correct. He composed songs on patrons, and he also invented many ragas. Answer is A. The title of Tansen was given by Raja Vikramajit Singh of Gwalior. Question number 9. Who among the following Mughal emperors shifted emphasis from illustrated manuscripts to album and individual portrait? See, every Mughal emperor had a unique liking for a special cultural activity, and in that way Shah Jahan is called the engineering king and Jahangir is called the king of paintings. So when you look at this, we may seem to take the answer as Jahangir, and this is also correct, because the answer to this question is C, Jahangir only. See how intricate the portrait of Jahangir is. In very detail it has covered him. And portrait reached greater heights during Jahangir's reign, and he encouraged the paintings depicting events of his own life, individual portraits and studies of birds, flowers and animals. So this is the portrait, individual portrait of the Jahangir himself. Question number 10. With reference to Mughal India, what are the differences between Jagirdar and Zamindar? Jagirdars were holders of land assignments in lieu of judicial and police duties, whereas Zamindars were holders of revenue rights. So, Zamindars were holders of land only. So, this option is wrong. Land assignment to Jagirdars were hereditary. No, they were non-hereditary. And revenue rights of Zamindars were not hereditary. No, this was hereditary. So, this is also wrong. The answer to this question is D, neither one nor two. Question number 11. Consider the following statements about the Charter Act of 1813. Please do read the features of this act, because this is also very important. It ended the trade monopoly of East India Company except for trade in tea and trade with China. Yes, this is correct. Before this act, the East India Company had monopolized the trade. That is, they are the only authorized people to import and export in India. So now the monopoly was removed. It asserted the sovereignty of the British Crown over the Indian territories held by the company. Yes, this is also correct. The revenues were now controlled by the British Parliament. No, this is wrong. The answer is A1 and 2. See, the act, it led the company to retain the possession of the territories and revenue for 20 years more, but without the prejudice to the sovereignty of the crown. And this act also allotted 1 lakh to promote education in India, and it also permitted the Christian missionaries to propagate English and preach religious education. Question number 12, with reference to Swadeshi movement. What are the correct statements? It contributed to the revival of indigenous artisan crafts and industries. Yes, this is correct, because Swadeshi movement was on the basis of self-reliance or Atma Shakti. So people wanted to revive the indigenous industries. National Council of Education was established as part of Swadeshi movement. This is also correct, because schools and other institutions, they wanted to the people who were in leading Swadeshi movement wanted to establish indigenous education. So both the statements are correct. The answer to this question is C, both 1 and 2. Question number 13, match the following pairs. All India Anti-Untouchability League by Mahatma Gandhi. This is correct. When he was in Erawada prison, he actually founded this organization in 1932. All India Kisan Sabha by Swami Sahajanand Saraswati. This is also correct. And it was in 1936. And Self-Respect Woman by E.V. Ramasamy Naikar, who is also popularly known as Periyar. Yes, this is also correct. The self-respect movement was started by the non-Brahmins in 1920s. So the answer to this question is D, 1, 2 and 3. Question number 14. With reference to the British colonial rule in India, consider the statements. Mahatma Gandhi was instrumental in the abolition of the system of indentured labor. Yes, this is correct actually. He abolished the system, but in South Africa. And you may get confused if it is correct with respect to British colonial rule in India. For this, we have to do the elimination method and find out which is wrong. In Lord Chelmsford War Conference, Mahatma Gandhi did not support the resolution on recruiting Indians for World War. This is wrong actually, because in 1918, the Montagu-Chelmsford reforms were announced, and the moderates were happy with it and the extremists were not happy. And Mahatma Gandhi, he told that he explicitly mentioned his support to recruit Indians for the World War. So this is wrong actually, statement 2. And consequent upon the breaking of Salt Law by Indian people, INC was declared illegal. Yes, this is correct. So the answer to this question is B, 1 and 3. Question number 15. With reference to Indian National Movement, consider the following pairs. Sir Tej Bahadur Sapru, President, All India Liberal Federation. Yes, this is correct. K.C. Neoji, member of Constituent Assembly. This is also correct. And Neoji was also the chairman of the first Finance Commission. P.C. Joshi, General Secretary of Communist Party of India. This is also correct. The answer to this question is D, 1, 2 and 3. See, as I said, in 1918, the Montagu report was published, and the moderates welcomed it and the extremists were unhappy with it. So the moderates, they formed Indian National Liberal Federation in 1919, and it was by Surendranath Banerjee and some of the prominent leaders, which included Tej Bahadur Sapru. So the answer is D. There is one more part 2 to today's video. Please do watch it. Have a nice day.